Now, over in Bulacan, a 50-foot-tall statue located on top of a mountain draws devotees seeking healing and miracles. Jack Batallanes gives us a look.
Padre Pio Mountain of Healing in San Jose del Monte City, Bulacan, attracts devotees seeking solace and spiritual healing. Located in Paradise Tree Village, this sanctuary features a 50-foot-tall statue of St. Pio, a way of the cross, and a chapel, creating a reverent and tranquil ambiance. Arwin Pajarillo and wife Jenny arrived early to avoid the Holy Week crowds.
Umiiwas kami kasi mahirap naman dito kung tulad yan maano, matarik. Mahirap pag may kasabay eh. Di mo masabi mamaya may aksidente o ano.
Ah, kaya
Opo, mas maganda rin kasi pag di masyado matao, relax lang yung ano, pag-akyat.
For 76-year-old Nena Aragon and her senior friends, they took on the challenging climb to the statue Thursday morning.
Maganda, with friends. Yes, parang mas thrilling ito, mas solemn kaysa, huwag naman sanang ano, kaysa iba. Maganda dito eh.
Administrator Rodel Rodriguez says, devotees pray for health, healing, inspired by Padre Pio's legacy.
Pagbaba nila, kumusta pagpunta mo sa Padre Pio? Grabe, talagang nakakuha sila ng kagalingan. Marami rito po, share ko na rin yung mga, number one, kagalingan. And then number two, yung mga gusto magkaanak. Napakarami po talaga rito ang mga testimonial.
Our Lady of Lourdes Grotto Shrine in Bulacan is also popular among devotees. The church is a replica of the Basilica in Lourdes, France. And the entire compound covers 25 hectares. A water spring at the shrine is a must visit. In 1965, the grotto was built by the couple Horacio Guanzon and Anita Guidotti Guanzon.
They just decided to go on a pilgrimage to Lourdes, France. Then they stayed there for several weeks. When they came back, my Lola was actually healed from cancer. Because of the miracle that happened to her life, this is what they did. My grandfather dreamed 3 times in one night that he was building a replica of the Basilica in Lourdes, France.
According to the shrine's administrators, they expect nearly 1 million visitors during the Holy Week break. Jack Batallanes, ABS-CBN News.
Now for many Filipino Christians residing outside their hometown, Holy Week is a chance to unite with their families and reconnect with their faith. They participate in one of the most common religious traditions in the Philippines, which is Visita Iglesia. Now, Jeffrey Arnaez tours one of the top local destinations where Filipinos can visit this Holy Week.
Even from afar, this structure at the top of a mountain in Batangas City can be seen. But this is not just any building. This is the Monte Maria International Pilgrimage and Conference Center, where the Mother of All Asia Tower of Peace is located. Considered the highest image of the Virgin Mary in the world, it stands at 98.15 meters tall or equivalent to 33 floors. Its face, which is made of bronze, was designed by national artist Ed Castrillo. One can ascend to the hand of the Virgin Mary, where the islands of Mindoro can be seen. Also here is the St. John Paul II Chapel, with a first-class relic or some pieces of hair of the former Pope.
Yung ambience niya maganda, malamig. Solemn po, ang sarap pong mag-bisita iglesia po dito.
Maganda po yung experience, maganda po yung lugar, maganda yung ambience. So punta po kayo dito sa amin sa Batangas.
Also found in Monte Maria is the Santo Niño de Praga Chapel, a replica of the Holy Infant of Prague in the Czech Republic, with a grand altar where you can pray intently while feeling the cool breeze from the sea.
Iniimbitahan po namin kayong lahat to experience the charm, the solemnity of the place. Lagi naming ini-encourage lahat ng tao na umakyat sa kamay ni Mama Mary, because there you can parang you're so close to the heart of Our Lady.
The Minor Basilica of the Immaculate Conception in Lipa is also frequently visited by visitors, especially during Lent for Visita Iglesia. It was established as early as 1581, destroyed and rebuilt in 1851. On April 8, 2017, parts were damaged due to an earthquake. It was temporarily closed and reopened after 8 months of renovation. Many admired the ceiling of the church, filled with murals and a golden altar. and also the black image of the Holy Child of Batangas or the Santo Niño de Batangan and the La Immaculada Concepcion de Batangan or the La Batanggenya.
Ang aming pong basilika dito sa Batangas City ay mahalaga para sa amin dahil bilang mananampalataya, dito kami humuhugot ng aming pag-ibig sa Diyos at sa aming kapwa.
The church reminds the faithful to prepare themselves before doing Visita Iglesia. In addition to Visita Iglesia, the church hopes that believers will continue to visit churches and meditate, and not just during the Lenten season. Jeffrey Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Transportation Department inspected Manila's main gateway, NAIA, and the Parañaque Integrated Terminal on Monday as part of preparations for the expected influx of travelers due to the Holy Week break. And here's what it found.
Benji, there is a possible lithium battery fire. I need backup.
The cabin crew of a local airline responded to a smoke coming out of a bag in the overhead bin, believed to be an explosion of a power bank. Thankfully, this is just a drill. AirAsia Philippines reminds passengers to check if their power banks are of good quality before bringing them on board.
Gusto natin na yung ating mga pasahero, whenever they fly, conscious din sila. Yung aming bang dalang power bank ay within limits. Worn out na or posibleng lumulobo na yung mga power bank. No, pwede itong i-report and pwede siyang mag-cause ng offloading ng mismong power bank.
The airlines, including Cebu Pacific and Philippine Airlines, say power banks should be 100 watt hours or about 20,000 to 27,000 milliampere hour depending on the voltage.
We use the formula po na milliamperes, we multiply it by the volts na indicated din po, kasama din po yan sa label, and then you divide it by 1,000 to get the watt hour rating.
The airline warned that power banks with no label may not be allowed on board.
Airlines say that power banks are allowed inside the aircraft, but passengers are reminded to always double check that their power banks are in good working condition. This as the airlines also prepare for the influx of passengers at airports this Holy Week.
Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista inspected the airport Monday as the number of passengers is expected to increase and reach its peak on Wednesday. Bautista says so far, the situation at the airport is normal and he assures passengers NAIA is clean.
Meron tayong regular na pest control, no? Every day, no? So siguro kung nagkaroon yan, mga isolated cases na rin yan, no? And siguro nga yung surot at saka na dapat hindi na natin pinag-uusapan yan, lalong-lalo na sa public, no? Dahil nakasira sa image ng ating bansa. Siguraduhin natin na yung mga ipis na yan, yung mga daga ay mawala dito sa airport.
He is also planning to remove some chairs at the arrival hall of Terminal 3 due to congestion, urging big families to welcome their arriving loved ones at home rather than at the airport.
Kung po pwede, wag naman masyadong marami yung sumusundo. No? Normally, kung minsan isang tao yung susunduhin, pero 10 yung mga family members na sumusundo. Kung minsan, isa o dalawang sasakyan yung dala nila. No? Siguro, hintayin nilang nila sa bahay.
Airport authorities also remind the public that certain hand carry items are not allowed.
Mahigpit pong ipinagbabawal na ipasok po dito sa pre-departure area at isama sa ating mga carry-on baggage. For example, lighters, ayan. Tapos yung mga liquids na gels na mahigit isang 100 ml. No, lahat po yun, dapat po naka-check-in siya. Yung mga matutulis na bagay.
Passengers are also advised to allot time for heavy traffic when planning to go to the airport. For Cebu Pacific, passengers should be at the airport 3 hours before a domestic flight and 4 hours before an international trip. Philippine Airlines, meanwhile, ask passengers to know the terminal and boarding gates assignment to avoid being late. Meanwhile, the transport chief also inspected the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, or PITX, together with other top government officials. They urge the public to be cautious when it comes to cybersecurity.
Paki-advise po ang inyong mga anak. Huwag niyo po ipo-post sa social media na wala kayo sa bahay at maglalakbay kayo kung saan-saan dahil makikita po ng mga magnanakaw na nag-post kayo yung address nyo na kung anong panahon na yan na walang tao sa bahay at maaaring pasukan po kayo.
Wala tayo natanggap na threat, but still our preparation or deployment of the police personnel, ina-assume natin na talagang yung worst scenario ay andyan.
Two bus drivers tested positive for drugs during a random drug test at PITX. A confirmatory test is still needed, but PITX officials already barred the drivers from working for the day. More passengers are expected to arrive at bus terminals and airports in the coming days. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.